Hey, what's up, guys? It's Tariq Salim, and today is the first video of JavaScript series, which talks about ES6 until ES9 of JavaScript, the next generations of JavaScript. And in this video, we'll talk about how to define variables in JavaScript. So let's get started. I'm in this directory folder. And I have an index.html file, and this file contains some basic HTML content and h1 tag and script, and the source of it is add.js, which related to the JavaScript file called add.js, which we will work on. And to test it, I'll just say alert hello world, for example, and save it. In Visual Studio Code, and you can run your HTML content and JavaScript and CSS content in a very useful extension in Visual Studio Code called Live Server. And if you searched with HTML Live Server, and the first result will be Live Server. To work with Live Server, to run it, just click the right button of mouse and choose open with Live Server, which will open in the default browser of your computer. Okay, and here I'm navigate to browser into the port which will Live Server work on, and it alerts hello world. So the JavaScript file works fine. As you a programmer of JavaScript, you know a default way to define a variable in JavaScript. Just say the variable, and I'll define variable person equals Tariq, for example. And this is the default way. So to show the result of that, I'll say document the query selector and select the h1 tag. The text content will equals person. Okay, and save it. Reload. I'll say the result is Tariq. Okay, so this is the default way to define a variable in JavaScript. And this way is the old way of defining variables in JavaScript. So the next generation has two other ways to define variables, like let and const. And before learning them, we just wanna know about variable. So if I make an if condition and say if person equals Tariq, I'll define it into something else. So I'll say variable person will equals John, for example, and save it and go to browser. You'll say it's John. So the program sees that person equals Tariq and check this condition. This condition represents a block of code of JavaScript. So it locks to person which equals Tariq, so it will perform this task to change the variable from Tariq to John. So it changes the value of that depends on this block of code. So the first thing about variables in JavaScript could be changed in block of code. It impacts outside. So we see this document query selector is outside of this block of code, and however that the block of code changes it and it impacts in outside of the code. So the first thing is to define a variable, and this is the first thing. Okay, so I will comment this and make another example. So I will just create an array called array will equals 1, 2, 3, 4 and save it. And here I'll make a for loop, variable i equals 0 and i more than or equals array dot length, then I plus plus, and then the loop here, and inside the loop I will change the variable person to, for example, do, and save it. See what will happen. Oops, just a change and to less than or equals array dot length, and go to browser. So you'll see that do is changing. So the person is Tariq, and the loop here happens, and the loop here for loop represents a block of code. So a block of code of JavaScript runs, and you can change the variable from outside inside this for loop or inside this block of code, and it will impact in outside of code. So I would say variable impacts to outside of block of code. And save it, reload again, you'll see variable impacts on outside of block of code. Done with this. The next thing to talk about is let. And what about let? Let, to define a variable, use a let. Just say let. And for example, person equals Tariq. And copy this to here. And uncomment that. And reload, you'll see Tariq. Okay. Just fine. So if I made an if block code and check the person if equals Tariq, I will change that to let person equals John do, for example, and save that, and see what will happen. It's output Tariq. So a difference from a variable change the variable from outside and impact outside of block code. So and let doesn't do that. And here if I set console the log person and reload it and go to console, so you see John do, but the result is Tariq. So why this happens? This happens because we output the console inside this block. So this block of code, the variable or the let is changing inside this block of code, but it does impact in outside of code. So outside of code takes the value of person from here, and this console.log person takes the value of it from here. Okay, so this is different than a variable. So using variable, changing the value of that inside the block code and make a result and change it also to outside of code. So we can make a comment here, and we can just say the first thing is let doesn't change the value variable in outside of block code. Okay, and save it. And the both of these ways to define a variable in JavaScript using let or variable, you can rechange and redefine the value of that. So for example, here we redefine the value of person into something, and in let we also redefine the value of person into some name. So these, to define a variable, you can redefine them, but the const is different than that. So let's talk about const. And just to define a variable using const keyword, so just write const person equals term and save it, and copy document query selector from here, and uncommon yet. And just reload, you'll see target. So if I made an if statement as usual we do like that and say person equals target, if person equals target, we can redefine it. So const person equals someone and say that reload, you'll see target and open the console, doesn't change. So however you make anything, it will not change. So for example, if we make something like that and reload, and you'll see syntax error, person has already been declared. So comments declare the variable one time inside the block of code, and it doesn't be declared anytime. So you can define it anytime. So you define it one time, you can redefine it. Okay, hopefully it makes sense. I'll just say here, const declares the variable one time and can't be changed. Okay, so thank you guys for watching this video, and hopefully you get a benefit, and hopefully it makes sense for you. And if you're on YouTube, don't forget to make subscribe and like for my video. And if you're on Facebook, so don't forget to make a like and follow our page to get updated on new videos. And thank you.